here, and of course this Beatles week on Ready, Steady, Go. But before we get to them, of course, we've got lots more stars for you. And let's start off with a number called Stagger Lee from America's most frantic threesome, the Isley Brothers.
And the moon was yellow, and the leaves came tumbling down.
About and swapping one record side of the record with another, hasn't it? What was the A side called?
Far Better Off Without You.
Is now the B side.
That's right.
And we're going to hear the B side called Girl Don't Come,
which is now the A side.
Which do you prefer yourself?
Personally, I prefer the previous A side, but
do
everybody
you?
Else likes this one, so I think
all right,
this one.
Let's hear it. Under Protest If Necessary from Sandy Shaw. Girl Don't Come.
Yeah. much, Sandy. I'm glad you decided to record that one because it was my favourite one too. And now our next group have gone rather folky on their new record, and it's called What Have They Done to the Rain? And here are The Searchers.
Just a little rain falling all around. The grass lifts its head to the heavenly sun. Just a little rain, just a little rain. What have they done to the rain? Just a little standing in the rain, the gentle rain that falls for years. And the grass is gone, the boy disappears, and rain keeps falling like helpless tears. And what have they done to the rain? Just a little breeze out of the sky. The leaves not dead as the breeze blows by. Just a little breeze with some smoke inside. What have they done to the rain? Just a little boy standing in the rain, the gentle rain that falls for years. And the grass is gone, the boy disappears, and rain keeps falling like helpless tears. And what
competition. These are the winners. They are Alan Angela Walsh, that's you, and Francis Walsh and Margaret Morrell from Sutton in Surrey. And they sent the most elaborate entry you've ever seen with a sort of preamble saying, to meet the Beatles on RSG, it means so very much to we. Our rhymes are here for you to see. Hope quantity wins, not quality. I think the last line went a bit astray. And then their rhyme goes, the Beatles eat tea at a table. The beetle at tea eats the table. That beetle that eats at the table, he'll eat us as late as he's able. The Beatles hate that beetle. He's beat at the table. At least tea he eats. Here, you can hold that for a minute.
Thanks.
So you met the Beatles, didn't
you? Yeah.
What do you think of them?
Oh, they were gorgeous.
What did they say to you?
Oh, well, George came up to me and he shook hands with me. And we gave them presents and they love their presents too. We gave them
it was a, they've never talked to any fans
you
before
really
in their lives. Yes,
well, look,
really
where's Billy J? Billy J, you meet Billy J. Kramer now. And you talk to him while we hear another number.
Hello, Keith.
Hi, Chris. I just overheard a couple of young ladies here saying they thought you were a more serious group than most, and quieter. Is this true? Do you think of yourselves more serious and quieter?
No, we're all soft.
You are?
We're all soft, we're all mad.
But do you think that perhaps singing quieter songs and not being so concerned with the beat wave means you will have a longer, more stable life in this business?
I hope so. Ask Mr. Tito Burns. He's all right.
That's his idea. What's the number going to be now, the flip side of this?
This is a song that John wrote in the Walton Jail. It's called This Feeling Inside.
Right. Anymore?
Oh, well, we never thought there ever was. Anyway, that was just the critics who didn't want to call it R&B.
Just a couple of the old-timers left, you know. Just the old folks left.
Well, we reckon it's difficult to see any new trend now. John, can you say what's coming next?
I haven't a clue. Probably American again, as well.
Could well be. He just mentioned American, which brings me on to the Tamla Motown people. Heard of Kim Weston?
Yes.
Touring here. Great singer.
Great.
Well, he's one of them, making a big impression. We've got a song from her called A Little More Love. So, can we start with that?
Yeah.
Right,
why not?
Done. Here's Kim Weston and A Little More Love.
Love.
ball, you've got to take me out for it. I want to have a ball, you've got to like my friends, but think I'm the best of all, cause I want a little more. A little more love to wipe my tears. Whenever you see me cry, laugh it all. When I tell a little lie,
worth a fortune between you. Can you tell us something about what you do with your money?
I sort of, with the money, I don't know, spend it a bit, you know. And, I've got a house for my dad up in Liverpool.
Do you spend very much time up there?
Yeah, when I get a chance, you know. Mind you, it's in the middle of a swamp, it's hard to get to.
No, it isn't, is it?
No.
Do you have to do all the housework when you got there? Have you got a maid?
No, but I make good gravy.
Do you think, Paul, that money can buy you happiness?
Yes, I am.
Yeah, it's enough help, you know, but...
Do you care very much about it?
What, money?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I wouldn't be laughing.
Baby's good to me, you know she's happy as can be, you know she said so. I'm in love with her and I feel fine. Baby says she's mine, you know she tells me all the time, you know she says so. I'm in love with her and I feel fine. I'm so glad that she's my little girl. She's so glad she's telling all the world. Baby buys the things, you know. He buys a diamond ring, you know. She said so. She's in love with me and I feel fine. You know she said so. I'm in love with her and I feel fine. I'm so glad that she's my little girl. She's so glad she's telling all the world that a baby buys a thing, you know. He buys a diamond ring, you know she said so. She's in love with me and I feel fine. She's in love with me and I feel fine.
What about this newspaper reporter? You're splitting up.
Hello, Robbie, I think it's...
it's one of those stories that started in the States, you know, and then they just by the time it gets over here, it's that.
You mean they run out of stories about you?
Yeah, they just make up rubbish over there.
Will you excuse me while I go and see the
corner?
Ringo, they tell me that hairstyle's going to be short. Does this mean you're going to shave it all up?
No, not me.
Oh, no.
I'm joking. You don't know what's underneath here, you see.
Brains?
Well, I haven't thought of that.
What's on the flip side of this record?
She's a Woman.
Is that another Lennon-McCartney number?
Yes, and Paul does the vocals.
Well, what about you doing some songwriting, Ringo?
Well, I'm trying, but it doesn't seem to work.
Have they got a sort of monopoly? They want to let you in?
Well, they're better than we are, you see. Well, than I am.
Are they?
Oh, they're very good, you know. Don't tell them.
Have you written any yourself at all?
One, but it was pinched off another one, so we couldn't do it.
If you were writing a song, Ringo, what would you write it on? Piano, guitar, I mean, would you pick out the tune on...
No, I just sort of hum it to myself, you know, and sing it, and then we get a guitar and they get a couple of chords going to it.
Right, well, let's sort ourselves out now and hear that flip. Are you ready?
Yes!
1, 2, 3, 4, She's a Woman.
Woman, yes.
I don't reckon there's anybody here cares much what the Beatles sing next as long as they sing, but we've got what I reckon is a great track from their forthcoming LP, and it's called Babies in Black.
Oh dear,
I forgot to ask you, when are you going to part company with those phone calls?
Tuesday.
Tuesday night.
Yes, please don't phone me though.
Oh,
hey!
Is it still difficult to get any privacy when you want to go out by yourself? Can you go out unrecognized?
Well, you go out recognized, but you know, you either go out in a car and sort of just wave back at people, or go out late at night to places where, you know, where you can have a
laugh. Play a bit safer, yeah. Do you? John, what about any ambitions at all the Beatles have got left?
No. We never had any anyway, don't we?
But you're enjoying life.
Oh, we love it, yeah. Oh, it's Fab Gear favourite pick.
I knew you were going to get that in.
I've been trying to get it all day.
John. Yes, what are you going to do after that? You've got another movie lined up.
We've got a bit of a holiday.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, and then the film, yeah.
When are you starting the movie?
I've got to write the songs for the film first.
That's going to be a bit of work, isn't it?
Yes.
How many songs
yes.
for the film?
About six new ones.
Good. Well, that's something to look forward to. Right now, let's say, well,
so do I,
round
please.
Off the show. Ready or what?
I look forward to it.
Good. Right, have a good holiday first.
Thank you.
Right now, we've got to say that that's all today. I'm sorry about that. But, as always, we'll be back next week with another Ready, Steady, Go. In the meantime, shall we round off with a little item that's Fab Gear, the lot.
Favorite pick.
And we'll call it Kansas City.